Hi, I'm Josh Miller. I am 32 years old and I live in San Francisco. I've been going to Cornerstone about 2+ years now. I would have never thought that I was going to be a prodigal son. At the time, when you're doing it, you don't think about that. I grew up in a Christian home, a very Christian home. My father was a pastor for longer than I've been alive. His father was a pastor, and his father was a pastor and a traveling evangelist. A question that I've heard my entire life was, are you going to be a pastor like your dad? I'd say no immediately, mostly because I just didn't want anybody else choosing my life for me. Over time, like, I felt like I was never going to be good enough. I would never measure up to what I felt that I was supposed to be and what all these people looked at me to be.
A warning sign. I missed the good part.
My dad pastored a church in Long Beach. When we decided as a family to move and take on a larger church and a church with more opportunity a couple hours away, when I moved, everything changed.
I started looking for excuses.
I had a real tough time making good friends, and I started to make some bad friends and started to ditch school and started to trail off a little bit. The new friends that I was making, there was no pressure of being anybody but their friend, and I wasn't a pastor's kid. I was just one of those guys that are just out, you know, causing trouble and ditching school and whatnot. I ended up getting kicked out of school at around 16, mainly for truancies, and that's really when the real partying started. My partying really started with just drinking a little bit and then drinking a lot all the time, and then next thing you know, I was smoking pot and now doing drugs. After a couple years of partying pretty heavily, I ended up moving to New Jersey with a friend of mine and in with his family. And his dad was a principal at a Christian school. And now I was trying to be good again. I felt God speaking to me in my life, but trying to do it on my own, it wasn't working at all. And just didn't last. I was in New Jersey for about a year, and I ended up moving back to California just to be around family and friends. When I moved back to California, I thought I'd try to get a job in a restaurant. And I started as a host, and I was a waiter, and then less than a year, I was a bartender. At that point, I didn't really believe that that was a big decision I was making, getting a job in a restaurant and starting to bartend. However, that's something that really influenced my life. The restaurant lifestyle is one of having cash in your pocket all the time. You go to work at night, go out with everybody afterwards, and drink up most of your money. You get up the next day and go to work and do it all over again, even drinking and partying at work. You just have a camaraderie of partying.
It's 2 a.m. I'm drunk again. It's heavy on my mind.
At this point, I was completely hiding my life with my family. I was somebody that I never would have thought that I was going to become. I thought that I wasn't going to drink and I wasn't going to have sex before marriage and all those things, and I believed those things. And then now it was like, what am I doing? Like, this is totally different than I thought I was gonna be. A family friend of ours who was a pastor in San Diego offered his place to stay, and with that, being involved in church again. And so I agreed to move because at that point in my life, I was a mess. I moved down to San Diego with this, I'm gonna try to do this, and I'm gonna try to, you know, be good. But I'm gonna do it my way, where I hide this little piece of my life where from time to time I'm gonna go and, you know, have a drink here. Next thing you know, those little times turn into humongous things in your life. San Diego was really where I hit complete rock bottom, and it snuck up on me completely there. All these things that I started to do again in San Diego, I didn't realize that they were so bad because I'd been pretty bad before. So it didn't seem as bad there, and so it happened more frequently, and with the addition of a girlfriend, partying all night long, making up excuses, and cheating on her, and I was a complete and total scumbag. I couldn't muscle my way into being a good person. I had been trying to do that for so long that I finally just gave up on it and accepted that I was maybe not a good person, that I may just be a total scumbag, and I just felt empty. Ultimately, what happened is my girlfriend, she came back and found me in bed with another girl.
Cold,
that moment was me hitting rock bottom.
Surrounds me now.
It was about as low as I could feel.
Lord, can you hear me now?
I knew that I couldn't do it on my own anymore.
Lord, can you hear me now?
And I just reached out to God, and I reached out to my parents. Lord, I told them everything and just asked them for help. It was the hardest, best feeling of my life. The healing began right there in that moment. And that light shining on my weakness is where all the strength that I have has come from. This world tells us that we need to be strong and we need to find this strength inside of ourselves. But I was nothing until I admitted to God that I was weak. As strong as I get, I'm never going to be strong enough. I need God. When I read the prodigal parable now, a lot of times it brings me to tears because of my life and just realizing God's love in my life.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
I just can't believe that God has stuck around and has just been right there for me and given me what I have now out of what I've been. I have a beautiful wife, I have a child on the way, and I have a purpose. It's never too late for somebody. I thought it was too late for me, but God had a different plan.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.